evening, the state television company Western Armenia represents the most important events of these days. Today's broadcast. Turkey and Azerbaijan have no right to be a UN member. The President of the Republic of Western Armenia. April 24 commemoration in Paris, Marseille, Lyon, Mandelieu-la-Napoule and Bron. The Turkish army lost tens of soldiers in northern Iraq. The commemoration event of the Delegation of Western Armenia in Tsitsernakaberd. The genocide against Armenians goes on till now. The President of the Republic of Western Armenia mentioned this in a conversation with Armenia Today in Tsitsernakaberd Memorial. According to him, the world should either take this into account or we should resist. He mentioned that Turkey and Azerbaijan are criminal states and have no right to be a UN member. Details are presented in the video. The commemoration event of the victims of the genocide against Armenians took place at 2 p.m. on April 24, 2021 in front of Comitas Station in Paris. Vahan Valit Gazazian, the Consul of the Republic of Western Armenia, laid a wreath and observed a moment of silence in memory of the victims, in the presence of citizens of Western Armenia, in accordance with the sanitary restrictions in Paris. Let us remind that the Council of People's Commissars of the Soviet Russia proclaimed the right of the Armenians of Turkish Armenia to self-determination to their independence on December 29, 1917. The state of Western Armenia was de facto recognized independent at the Paris Conference on January 19, 1920 and the Yerevan San Remo Conference on May 11, 1920 by the Supreme Light Council, whose border with Turkey was subject to arbitration by US President Woodrow Wilson on November 22, but was not recognized by the UN authorities because occupied by Turkey. Let us remind that in 1894 to 1923, the indigenous Armenian population was subjected to genocide in the occupied territories of Western Armenia, which was carried out by three successive Turkish governments. In Marseille, Member of the Parliament Violeta Agayan and the Minister of Internal Affairs of the Republic of Western Armenia Martiros Shahbazyan led a wreath and observed a moment of silence in memory of the victims in the presence of citizens of Western Armenia in accordance with the sanitary restrictions in Marseille. Let us remind that the Council of People's Commissars of the Soviet Russia proclaimed the right of the Armenians of Turkish Armenia to self-determination to their independence on December 29, 1917. The state of Western Armenia was de facto recognized independent at the Paris Conference on January 19, 1920 and the San Remo Conference on May 11, 1920 by the Supreme Light Council, whose border with Turkey was subject to arbitration by US President Woodrow Wilson on November 22, but was not recognized by the UN authorities because occupied by Turkey. Let us remind that in 1894 to 1923, the indigenous Armenian population was subjected to genocide in the occupied territories of Western Armenia, which was carried out by three successive Turkish governments. In Lyon, the head of the Parliament of the Republic of Western Armenia, Leonardo Basmajan, led a wreath and observed a moment of silence in memory of the victims, in the presence of citizens of Western Armenia, in accordance with the sanitary restrictions in Lyon. The presence of Father of Saint Jacques de Lyon Armenian Apostolic Church, Isaac Hekimian, who accompanied the ceremony with a prayer, was a great honor. Let us remind that the Council of People's Commissars of the Soviet Russia proclaimed the right of the Armenians of Turkish Armenia to self-determination to their independence on December 29, 1917. The state of Western Armenia was de facto recognized independent at the Paris Conference on January 19, 1920 and the San Remo Conference on May 11, 1920 by the Supreme Light Council, whose border with Turkey was subject to arbitration by US President Woodrow Wilson on November 22, but was not recognized by the UN authorities because occupied by Turkey. Let us remind that in 1894 to 1923, the indigenous Armenian population was subjected to genocide in the occupied territories of Western Armenia, which was carried out by three successive Turkish governments. In Mandelieu-la-Napoule, Mandelieu-la-Napoule Mayor Sebastian Leroy, President of Armenia Region Caroline Ohanesyan, the head of flag bearers Jean-Jacques Guy, President of Veterans and Resistance Fighters of Armenian origin Jean Ghazarosyan, President of Armenian Veterans Vrej Abrahamyan, and the representative of the National Council of Western Armenia Parul Shahumyan led wreaths and observed a moment of silence in memory of the victims under Perch Melikseyan's Duduk music in the presence of citizens and flag bearers of Western Armenia in accordance with the sanitary restrictions. President Jean Ghazarosyan awarded Mandelieu-la-Napoule Mayor Sebastian Leroy with Sur Medal in the name of Western Armenia. Let us remind that the Council of People's Commissars of the Soviet Russia proclaimed the right of the Armenians of Turkish Armenia to self-determination to their independence on December 29, 1917. The state of Western Armenia was de facto recognized independent at the Paris Conference on January 19, 1920 and the Yerevan-San Remo Conference on May 11, 1920 by the Supreme Light Council, whose border with Turkey was subject to arbitration by US President Woodrow Wilson on November 22, but was not recognized by the UN authorities because occupied by Turkey. Let us remind that in 1894 to 1923, the indigenous Armenian population was subjected to genocide in the occupied territories of Western Armenia, which was carried out by three successive Turkish governments. In Bron, Bron Mayor Jeremy Preyot and the head of the Parliament of the Republic of Western Armenia, Leonardo Basmajian, led a rev and observed a moment of silence in memory of the victims, in the presence of citizens of Western Armenia, in accordance with the sanitary restrictions. This event for the victims of the genocide against Armenians, organized by Bron Mayor, is the first, and officials in Western Armenia wanted to pay tribute to this initiative, sponsored by the mayor of Bron, Jeremy Preyot. Let us remind that the Council of People's Commissars of the Soviet Russia proclaimed the right of the Armenians of Turkish Armenia to self-determination to their independence on December 29, 1917. The state of Western Armenia was de facto recognized independent at the Paris Conference on January 19, 1920 and the Yerevan-San Remo Conference on May 11, 1920 by the Supreme Light Council, whose border with Turkey was subject to arbitration by US President Woodrow Wilson on November 22, but was not recognized by the UN authorities because occupied by Turkey. Let us remind that in 1894 to 1923, the indigenous Armenian population was subjected to genocide in the occupied territories of Western Armenia, which was carried out by three successive Turkish governments. Turkey's army hit Kurdish fighters in northern Iraq in a new ground and air offensive, as a result of which 38 Turkish soldiers have been killed. This is stated in the statement of the PKK published by Firat Kurdish News Agency on April 26, e-Daily reports. On Saturday, April 24, the Turkish army launched a new ground offensive against the PKK in Iraqi Kurdistan. According to a statement issued on Monday, Kurdish partisans have shown fierce resistance with at least 38 Turkish soldiers killed. According to Firat, Turkish troops descended from helicopters to several heights, trying to penetrate the guerrilla tunnel system using unknown chemicals. The Kurdish Workers' Party fighters operate in small groups, carrying out several operations against the occupying forces, including the use of sniper subversive tactics. The occupation operation launched by Turkey on April 23, 2021 in the Media Defense Zone in Medin, Avashin and Zab regions continues. Our guerrilla units carried out large-scale operations against the invaders, inflicting heavy casualties on the occupiers, the PKK said in a statement. The delegation of the Republic of Western Armenia, led by the President Armenak Abrahamyan, will visit Tsitsernakaberd, the memorial of the victims of the genocide against Armenians, in order to pay tribute in memory of innocent victims. The Republic of Western Armenia will lay a wreath in the memorial. Afterwards, President Armenak Abrahamyan will present a commemorating speech. Two former Asala fighters will be awarded with Sur medals of Western Armenia. The anthem of the Republic will be played. The entrance is free. Those who wish can participate. Now we present you Zartonken Sabal Khorotik. Is available on the official website of Western Armenia TV. This was all for today. Goodbye.